We have some aluminum tubing that we're working on today. This came straight out of an air conditioning condenser. We cleaned this hole right here. Of course, we didn't do any pre-cleaning. This has years worth of contaminants on this. We want to show you why our flux works so great. With aluminum, you gotta have something that's gonna help you tell where you are. It really is important with aluminum that you have some type of a temperature guide. If you don't know where you are heat-wise, you can burn this aluminum up very easily. The flux tells you where you are. The flux turns real thin and watery, and actually the aluminum will brighten up when the flux is at the right temperature. I always let the flux do its job. It tells me where it is. It tells me when to add my rod, and you'll see here in a second. I'm using a propane torch. Just gonna heat up my rod just a little bit. I heat it up just so I can dip it into my flux, just like that. And gonna preheat a little bit, and then, as you see, lay my rod in there. Right after the flux does its work. There we go. Now I'm going to add a little bit of rod. Just like that. Now that's, of course, on the clean piece, but how does it work on dirty aluminum? I'm just going to see how the flux cleans it. Right there, it's telling me to go ahead and lay my rod in. And that's exactly what I'm going to do. That seals at 30,000 PSI. I let it air cool just for a few moments. You always want to let it air cool, of course. It just makes it a little bit stronger. So if you're working on anything aluminum, always remember that. I'm just cleaning this flux off. Water and a wire brush is all you need to get that flux off. It's a, as you can see, it's an easy cleanup. This is what the Super Alloy 5 looks like when you polish it. Notice there's no difference between the Super Alloy 5 and the aluminum. Now the other zinc-based rods you'll see on the market at the car shows or at the swap meets or on the internet, again, a lot of those are zinc-based and they won't polish like this. A lot of them do not have fluxes, so they won't flow like this. This is why we're the number one selling aluminum rod in the country, let alone number one in cast iron, stainless steel, and of course our pop metal rods.